Hi everybody. I apologize, it has taken me so long to get a skincare video done. I promised a friend of mine from high school that I would do a skincare video, and Linda, big apologies to you. I am getting it done because I'm going to see you tonight at that committee meeting, and I'm going to be so embarrassed that I have not gotten this done before now. And I know there are others of you that I have also promised. My apologies to you as well. Skincare. We'll jump right in and hope I can get through this. In the morning, I don't use any soap on my face at all. I don't use any cleanser. I just rinse my face with tepid water and pat it dry. The next thing that I do, okay, we've patted my face dry. I should have just taken you with it, through it, and just done it, and it would have been clear in my mind what it was I was doing. The next thing I would do after patting my face dry would be to use the Dr. Denese Pro C Illuminating Cell Defense Pads. And they look like this. I cut them in two. Plenty enough to go over my face, neck, décolletage, backs of my hands. That's where I use everything when I refer to my face. Those are the places it's going. And these do have a bit of an odd color, kind of an off-white color. If you would happen to purchase any, there's not anything wrong with them. And this is a stabilized form of vitamin C, so no concerns that the vitamin C is coming in this particular type of container and being exposed to the air and degrading, and stabilized form of vitamin C. The next thing that I do is spritz my face with this Paula's Choice Toner, normal to very dry skin. I don't really have any particular belief in that toners do phenomenal things for our skin so far as reducing pore size or, well, a lot of things. But this does help me with my dry skin, and it also gives me a little bit of extended time that I have moisture on my skin. To me, the objective of using a moisturizer, a lot of the objective, is to prevent transepidermal water loss. Our skin is a dynamic organ. It loses moisture. My objective is to keep it all in, so this buys me a little bit more time, since losing that moisture once I've dried my face, that losing that moisture is going to happen in about 60 seconds, and I'm just not that fast anymore. So I spritz my face, and I can't find my little spritz bottle. I've got it in a little bottle. I spritz my face with this. And then the next thing would be my moisturizer. And in the daytime, I use the Dr. Denese Hydro Shield Hydrating Dream Cream. And it is sort of a peach color cream. Really do like this. And under my eyes, I use Clinique All About Eyes Rich. There is a plain Clinique, and there is Clinique All About Eyes Rich, and that's the one that I use. And one of the few eye creams I have ever used that actually provided hydration under my eyes, so I really like that. And then I let everything just kind of soak into my skin before I even begin to attempt makeup. And the next thing that I do is sunscreen, a good zinc oxide physical sunscreen. Either Skin Active's Advanced Protection SPF 30, which is primarily zinc oxide, or Eucerin, Sensitive Skin Everyday Protection Face Lotion, also SPF 30, and again, primarily a zinc oxide preparation. Both of these sunscreens are awesome. They do extremely well for me under foundations. I have had no breakouts from either one of them. Zinc is very soothing and calming to the skin. If you've ever taken care of a baby, or if you've had kids and you've used Desitin, then you know the benefits of zinc. So very good for my skin with rosacea, and I am not going to go over any products that I use for rosacea. I did a video about rosacea, so you can go back and look at that video if you think you might have rosacea or if you know you have rosacea. And to my knowledge, I don't think I've changed anything that I use for that since then. So that takes care of daytime. And again, everywhere, face, neck, décolletage, backs of hands, that's where sunscreen goes. In the evening, first thing is to remove makeup, and the first makeup I remove is usually my eye makeup. And where did my eye makeup remover go? I've used a lot of eye makeup removers, many, many eye makeup removers. I always go back to this. It is Almay oil-free eye makeup remover pads, and really, really easy on my eyes, no burning, no greasy residue, removes anything I've put on my eyes. The pads, already pre-wetted pads, just easy, easy, and easy to find. The next thing I remove is my face makeup, and I do that with the Resist Optimal Results Hydrating Cleanser from Paula's Choice. I really do like this cleanser. You can either use this solely, or you can just use it as an eye or as a face makeup remover like I do. And I get a couple of pumps, rub it onto my skin, massage it into my skin, and then I tissue that off, and or I rinse it off. And then you could go back, and if you have really, really dry skin, I've actually gone back and then washed my face, gone back a second time and washed my face with this. And that does work extremely well. What I like to do, if I can, if my skin is not being super dry, is once I've removed my makeup with this, then I get the Olay 2-in-1 Daily Facial Cloths for Sensitive Skin. And these are just dry cloths that you wet and wash your face with. Duh. And they work really well and don't seem to cause a lot of dryness, don't cause irritation. And I just really do want my face clean. And I am religious. I am religious about all of this. I will go without sleep, whatever it takes, but I do my skincare. And most of these Dr. Denese products, in fact, all of these that I think I'm showing you now, I've used all these Dr. Denese products for at least 10 years. So I feel like it is a reasonably priced line. I feel like there are good actives in them. And that was part of why it was so hard for me to make a skincare video, because I wanted to tell everybody what I thought was so great about each and every individual product. And I won't do that. But I do think she has an amazing line, great value, and no, I'm not getting any compensation to say that. I don't get any free products from her. I don't get anything from anybody. I don't get ad money from YouTube. I get nada. So my opinion, solely my opinion of these products, and I think they're awesome. Okay, sidelined with that. The next thing, where was I? Jeez, why do I do that? Somebody, anybody, tell me. what was I talking about? Okay, I was talking about using these. Okay, so I've cleaned my face. Then I'm going to pat my face dry. Then, okay, we're going to have week one and week two. We're going to pretend it's week one. I'm going to use the Advanced I'm going to use the Advanced Firming Facial Pads, the glycolic product. It's just a pad that I'm going to use over my face, neck, décolletage, backs of hands. And under my eyes, I will use the Firming and Resurfacing Eye Pads. And I also cut these in half, although those are not cut in half. Ample product, again, to go under, certainly with these, to go under both eyes. Then apply my HydraShield Eye Serum under my eyes, on my eyelids. apply my face serum, the Dr. Denese Hydroshield Ultra Moisturizing Face Serum. Let those soak in 5 or 10 minutes. Then apply my eye cream under my eyes, on my eyes. This is again the Clinique All About Eyes Rich, as opposed to just the plain Clinique All About Eyes. Followed by my moisturizer, which is a mix of the Dream Cream and the Skin Actives Vitamin A Cream Twilight Awakening. And really great ingredients in this also, but I promised I wasn't going to go in that. This has got jojoba, sea kelp, and a lot of niacinamide and other vitamins, and awesome combo. And it looks like this. And that would be it for nighttime. That would be all the products I would use. And then if it was week two, other than the rosacea stuff, which I'm not going to talk about, if it was week two, I would be using a washing my face and not using the glycolic product, but instead using Atralin, which is a tretinoin product. And I would use the tretinoin all over everywhere, except not clear up to my eye, not clear up to any mucous membrane, but everywhere else. And I do not use this on my neck. I apologize. I do not use a tretinoin on my neck. I haven't used it on my décolletage. I have used it on the backs of my hands. Necks are really, you can get in trouble with necks, and I'm not going there with this. This is prescription. This is heavy duty, and not going to use it on my neck. So I would apply that, and then I would go back to everything else just the same. I am just substituting either the glycolic acid product, the advanced firming facial pads, or I'm using this. So 1 week I'm using this, 1 week I'm using this, and everything else stays the same. And I hope that makes sense. So that's my skincare. That's what I do. I have used this for 11 years, I think, at least. I have used all of the Dr. Denese products that I have shown you. I have used for almost 11 years the Paula's Choice Toner. I don't know how long I've used it, several years. This is a new product, so I have not used it all that long, but I really do like it. And that's all I can think of to tell you. Oh, one more product. If you do have particular issues with hyperpigmentation, spots, age spots, let's call them solar lentigines. How about that? This is PCA Skin, and you can see, I don't know how long I've had this, a good long while. I haven't used much of it. It is a pigment gel. This is like a peel in a bottle, and I would never, ever, ever dream of using this all over my face. This has got several acids in it. It also has 2% hydroquinone. You can use prescription 4% hydroquinone, and this is inexpensive. I think this is $20 at Walmart, even without insurance, but you do have to have a prescription for it. This has lactic acid. It has, why do they make such light print on such a light background? It has kojic acid. It has, what else? Where are the actives? Well, it's saying the only active ingredient is 2%. It has azelaic acid, which is actually one of the products that I use, prescription products that I use for rosacea. It has citric acid. You can put this on a spot, and if you use it 3-4 nights in a row, it will literally just peel a spot. And if you let it go for another 3 or 4 days, allow that to, you know, be totally normal skin again and not a dry patch, and attack it again, eventually you can get rid of a spot with this. I had a spot that was coming up on my hand, and that's primarily what I've done with this, although I think I've also used it on a couple of spots on my legs. But just be really careful with it, because it will absolutely peel. It will absolutely make your skin peel. And I don't know how much longer this is going to be available. There's a whole issue with the FDA and products containing hydroquinone that are over the counter. But to my knowledge, at this point in time, this is still available at drugstore.com. So that's it. I'll shut up now. And I hope this made sense. If it didn't, let me know, and I'll try to make sense out of it. Thanks for watching, guys. I will see you soon. Linda, I will see you tonight.